Christian Ock here for Insight Media. It's SID 2023. I'm in the Seoul Semiconductor booth. We're going to take a look at their micro-LED technology. So they call this micro-LED technology. It's actually really a mini-LED technology because the devices are 200 microns square. But that's I guess what they call it is their MC4 device. And currently they're working on, or actually have produced this MC2 device, which is, that's 200 by 200. The MC1 is the one that's in development. It's going to be about 100 by 100 microns. So still kind of at the edge of micro-LED technology. Now, what's particularly interesting about their approach here is that almost all LED displays are made two ways. The 95% of the vast majority are made with discrete red, green, and blue LEDs that are placed on a substrate, a PCB or a glass substrate. Alternatively, you can take blue LEDs and do some color conversion to create red and green LEDs out of that as well. So what Seoul Semiconductor has done is a vertically stacked LED. So here they show it here. Here's your three standard wafers that you put side by side on a device. But what they do is take those three wafers and they stack them vertically instead of side by side. So these are three epi layers stacked one on top of each other. That have to be bonded on in a wafer scale process and then separated into individual die. That is not easy to do. And I'm sure the processes to do that is very complex, and the yields must be, well, I can't imagine what the yields would be. But the clear advantage here is, one, you have a much better fill factor, right? So instead of having to spatially put them side by side RGB, you now stack them so you've got much more black area around that that pixel, which helps with contrast. In addition, having them side by side can actually it can have a color shift as you go from one side to another. So for the red LEDs, you might have a red hue when you're looking at it from the left side, and from the right side might have a little bit of a blue hue. So you eliminate that theoretically if you stack them vertically. It also has an advantage in transparency, again, because you've got much more open area here now, so there's less space taken up by the LEDs themselves. So all these things add up to all these benefits that they're talking about here. Lower manufacturing costs, transfer costs, give a better color, better black, a better transparency. And so those are real benefits. This has actually been commercialized at this point. They have integrated them, they're showing here at the booth, into a number of different modules here. So they've got some here that this MC2 panel is into this device here, a display that's 160 by 180 with a 0.9 millimeter pitch. They have another one over here, a 13.6 inch one. And here they have a little bit smaller pitch, a 0.625 millimeter pitch. So you can see that they're really targeting the application here is a 4K 108 inch display. So this pixel pitch is clearly too big for a desktop monitor. You'd need something about half that pixel pitch to get down to the pixel, a monitor size pixel pitch. But it's very impressive that they can do this. These are all on PCB backplanes. So if they want to really get to micro LED size, they're going to have to go to smaller devices, smaller than 100 microns. They'll have to get to 50, 20, 10. And vertically stacking that's going to be a much, much bigger challenge. In addition, they probably will have to go to a glass active matrix backplane as well, which also creates additional challenges and opportunities. So, but But great step here in starting to work with mini LEDs to create these vertically stacked devices, which can create a nice path toward micro LEDs. So Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.